All right. I've been wanting to do a video on Sekiro for a long time. And I was trying to stream it, and my internet just was not having it. So we're gonna try a video with voice. I've never done one of these. Like, I've done stream highlights before, but never voiceover just by myself. So this will be interesting. We did a stream of this. The stream quality looks like complete garbage. But it is up on the full streams channel if you want to check it out. But basically, the premise here is we're gonna try to beat Sekiro, or at least get as far as we can without using prayer beads. Prayer beads are health upgrades and posture upgrades. I'll show you what that means when we get into combat. This game is definitely my favorite combat game out there. Like, if I were to name my five favorite boss fights in any games, I think like at least three or four would be from this. Then probably one from like Final Fantasy VII Remake. We're not gonna go charmless. We can at least have some semblance of health. We can use heals, but I'm not sure how long we'll be able to go before we're just gonna be losing our entire health bar in one hit. Might have to figure something else out at that point, but for now, let's give this a go. Before we get this challenge started, I'd like to thank Dragon City for sponsoring this video. Dragon City is free to play and available on both Android and iOS. Collect over 1,000 different dragons and build your own dragon empire. You can breed two dragons to get new ones, hatch them, and feed them to evolve. Then you can train your dragons and take them to battle in order to power them up. There are some really fun PvP modes that let you fight against other dragon masters and even challenge your friends. You can click the link in the description to get a special free reward: 15,000 food, 30,000 gold, and 10 gems. These rewards will only be available for new users and only for the next 7 days. You can download the game right now through the link in the description to get your exclusive reward and start hatching dragons today. Thanks again to Dragon City for sponsoring this video.
So you can see our health bar down there in the bottom left. And our posture or stamina is right there in the bottom of the middle. So those values are never going to increase if we do make it all the way through like this. It's the only Souls game I've played so far, and it's really fun. First sort of boss, mostly a tutorial. As you can see by how quickly he dies. And I still get hit, of course. Alright. Well, we did better than the stream already, because I died to that guy when I forgot to heal. But the stream made it all the way to Guardian Ape. So we'll see if we can get there today, at least. This is definitely a lot different than my usual video style. With the text. I've been using text for like a year and a half or something. And there are a few reasons. One is that I don't think my voice is the typical YouTuber energy. You know, it's pretty chill, monotone, has absolutely no expression. A lot of people tell me, like, "Hey, are you tired?" Like, no, not really. That's just how my voice is. So I've been a fan of the text. And also, I can do things with text that I can't do with voice. I can give more emphasis to the music, put more personality without being intrusive. Like, it's more like watching the game being played than watching someone play the game. But it'll be nice to try voiceover at least once. Not even voiceover, just voice in general. It works on streams for sure. I forgot. I was trying to Makiri counter that, but we don't have Makiri counter. That boss here meant to die too. Then he cuts off your arm. But we get a prosthetic arm. So far this is a normal playthrough, up until we get 4 prayer beads. It's almost like a heart piece in Zelda. You can see the counter right there, where you get 4 heart pieces and then you get a heart container. It's basically identical. You may have noticed that the blood is green. Mostly because YouTube would probably get mad if I left the red blood on. And also because it's actually the same thing that Ocarina of Time did back in 1998. Ganon used to vomit red blood in one of the ending cutscenes. And then in a newer version, they changed it to green, so I thought that was pretty funny. That's the exact same thing that they do here. The mild blood setting is just green blood. So obviously you can beat Sekiro with no prayer beads, because you can beat it without getting hit at all. So this is more about can I beat Sekiro without prayer beads than can anyone. Hopefully it'll be a fun challenge without being... Like, if it just turns into a no-hit run, maybe we'll switch to no healing or something, so we can at least take, like, one hit before dying. But we'll see how it goes. Okay, there's the first mini-boss. So those red attacks... You have to watch out because you can't block them. It's kind of like a quick time event. The sweeps you have to jump over. These thrust attacks, you can either Makiri counter them, which we'll get to later, or you can parry them, or run away. And the grabs, you pretty much have to run away. So you have to pick, like, within a split second, which of those three things to do. Oh, come on. So far this guy has just done the sweeps, but some of them will have multiple. Yeah, oh, there's a grab. Probably should have healed. The nice thing about Sekiro, though, is... you can die twice. Sometimes more than twice. So that's not really like a real death. Alright, this one's almost over. Yep. First one's not too bad. So there's a prayer bead, which we're never gonna use, and a gourd seed, which increases the number of times you can heal. Although, like I said, eventually we might just die in one hit, so that won't matter either. But for now, it's good. Could be a giant guy around here. Best way to deal with them is to not deal with them. By sneak attacking. Oh no. I have 0 health. Oh. There's death number one. Oh. Fighting two guys at once is never very easy, regardless of how weak they are. I wish you could push them off a cliff. That guy's floating. Nice. Pretty easy so far. Obviously we're not into the challenge part yet. It's not easy on your first playthrough, of course, but I've played it probably like 4 or 5 times. Oh, I thought that was the way forward. it was actually this way. Then you jump up. I'm a lot better at the boss part than the enemy and environment part. Okay, we got another boss coming up. This guy. Good thing he's tied to the wall. He does a lot of grabs. They'll pretty much one-shot you if he lands any. Yeah, like that. I'm alive. A little bit. He's basically like a pro wrestler ogre. Those little red circles at the top are the health bars. So he basically has two health bars. Why is this guy here? That could get annoying. Oh, come on. That's a cliff, really? Or if I can just, no. Oh. Okay, that kind of worked. You still got this. Never mind. Can we get that guy? Oh, he's all the way up there. I don't think we can get him beforehand. I mean, we could, but we'd be sacrificing all the free hits we get on this guy while he's tied to the wall. So, hopefully he just doesn't aggro this time. Oh, barely got out of that one. Alright, good first phase. Guy hasn't shown up yet. Oh no. Got way too greedy, but we're still alive. Getting a little greedy. Probably back off a little. Okay, there we go. Not too bad. Ideally, we can do this through stealth. This guy first. And this one. Well, that went well. I wonder if I can run up and get the boss. Yep. Okay. Nice, so we took half the boss's health bar. Oh, I don't have cheery counter yet. Now we just have to do the second phase. Oh. He's close, though. Oh, not quite. There we go. Kinda cheesed that one a little. This is a sort of boss. Unique boss. Just a big snake. Gotta be real stealthy. That was a little risky, but... this one is a lot scarier on the first playthrough. Once you know what to do, it's pretty easy. And now we run. Well, he got me. I'd usually like to have firecrackers for this one, but we can probably manage without it. Okay. More free hits. It's like a quarter of his health bar. Okay. First phase down. Probably save the heal. Just running into a corner. What even happened there? Alright, nice. First try. I remember that one being hard on the first playthrough, but I guess they all were. So when you kill a big boss like that, you get to increase attack power, which is basically the only attribute that's going to be increasing for us. Because we can't do this one. Enhance physical attributes is the prayer beads. But we can do attack power. I know there's something up here. I did this on stream too. I don't remember if it's a gourd seed or a prayer bead. I think it was a prayer bead. Yeah, okay. So now we have 4 prayer beads. So from here on out, we're at a disadvantage. Because this would be the point where you upgrade your health and posture. So now the challenge really begins. The nice thing about it is that it starts off normal and then it just gets progressively harder. I don't know if we're gonna beat the whole game like this, but I'll get as far as I can. The nice thing about this game is that it's hard without making you farm like a lot of other games. Like, you can farm and it'll help a little bit, but really, the thing holding you back is just practicing. Ow. We definitely want Makiri counter. Oh yeah, combat arts. I never used these, ever. Well, there's one spot in the game where I use this one. But I usually just don't bother. And they're probably really good, but oh well. I've just never learned them. Don't let PETA see this part. The firecrackers can really help. Let's try them. Oh, I'm kind of in a bad spot. Oh, we're burning. Okay, well, the burning doesn't matter, at least. There we go. You can do that on the horse boss that we just fought, but that one's pretty manageable without it. Okay, ignored that one. Nice thing about this one is it only has one health bar. It's very different than the other fights. Like, it's much more erratic. It's not like a choreographed thing. Like, some of the sword fights later are very choreographed. Oh, so this one's a cool change of pace. Oh, that was bad. That might be it. Yeah. Alright. Well, that was very close. But we got it. That's the Makiri counter, where you stand on the spear when they thrust attack. The top of this castle is the first boss that's probably going to be hard. And the challenge will really start to take effect there. Because we should have like 1 or 2 prayer bead upgrades by then. Oh yeah, and there's this guy. Let's just take out that guy. You're invincible while you're in the death blow animation, so sometimes you can get away with killing those guys. Not this time. Yeah, like there. Okay. Oh, come on. We killed them all. If I had just been able to get away, we probably could have got that guy. Okay, how about we lure him down here? And then sprint up. Oh, okay. He was ready for that. Okay. Now we got them all. Now we can just die to this guy. What if we just. Okay, this works extremely well. Okay, well. My other strategy looks kind of dumb now. We can probably even wait and. Oh, whoops. Yeah. Get a nice health bar off of this guy. Well, this is gonna become way easier. I try to jump on. Breaking your posture doesn't have to be a bad thing if you're playing with the charm. If you ever get the posture broken on the last hit of an attack, then you regain all of it and you don't take any damage, so it can actually be a good thing. But if you're playing charmless, which is like the harder difficulty, then you take a bunch of damage if you don't perfectly reflect something. Yeah, like there, that was no problem. Alright. Yeah, that was a much easier strategy. Sixth prayer bead. Stealth kill. I usually just run away from those ones. Because they do stuff like this. There's just no need to do this part. This boss is either really easy or he'll kill you in like one hit. Let's see how he is today. Okay, so far pretty easy. Oh, that's... I tried a Makiri counter, but it's... Oh. That's basically the two ways that that fight can go. First phase of the... Oh, no. No. Yeah. That was sneaky. One time I was fighting this guy with a Bluetooth controller, and I died to him like 20 times, and then I plugged in the controller and beat him on the first try with no problem. So that delay, like you don't even notice it that much, but that delay is huge, for this fight at least. Wow, I'm terrible. Oh. So even if you block it, this guy will still damage you. You have to parry it. It's basically a tutorial that says like, hey, you need to actually start parrying stuff now. You're not gonna make it past the next boss if you don't. Okay. That was bad. Now we have 7 prayer beads. You could definitely go get more, so we're gonna be missing basically two prayer bead upgrades for this one. That's why we needed a Kiri counter. I always get hit by the second last attack of that, which is the worst hit to get hit by. Then you automatically get hit by the strongest part, which is the end. If it breaks it on the last hit, that's fine, because then you can just regroup and you'll get all your posture back. Okay. Yeah, we got resurrection back. I can heal too. So now he mixes it up and adds a sweep attack. So now you have to be careful, choose the right option. If you choose the wrong one, you're gonna automatically get hit. It's kind of designed that way. It's pretty cool. No. Oh, I'm alive? Okay. Well, we'll take it, I guess. We have basically no health, like, whatsoever. Do I risk just pelleting? Probably not gonna go too far without healing at all. Pellet? Nice. Okay, that heals us slowly over time. But we only have a limited number that we can use. Oh, I screwed it up again. Got too greedy. On the stream, we beat him on the first try. We're actually doing much worse than I was doing on the stream, somehow. Oh, ideally, you want to get into a rhythm. Oh, that's a grab? He never grabs. If you can get into a good rhythm in the first phase, yeah, this is decent so far, you can get him down before he's taken a lot of damage. Like, he's already, like, halfway through the posture bar. Oh, I don't know what I was doing there. Managed to deflect that one. Even though we've only done, like, 10% of his health. Okay, that should be it. Okay, that was a nice little ring. That was going well. Okay, now we got him. I mean, it can come down to which attacks he uses. Like, if he... What is that? Yeah, he's not looking too good in this first phase. Like, he was... That was a very favorable attack pattern. Like, it's never unfair, but it'll occasionally be some good RNG on the which moves he uses. Okay. Yeah, see, that one went, like, really well without a hitch. The problem is that he has a hidden third phase. Alright, here we go. He usually does a thrust attack right at the beginning. Yep. Okay. And then lightning. Got it. Oh, we have no health whatsoever. Does it deal damage to you? I didn't know that. If I had known that, I would have healed. But... Oh well. Let's go again. Okay, we kind of just mastered that fight out of nowhere. That was like 60 seconds for two faces. Okay, let's not screw this up this time. Now do the lightning. Yeah, it does deal damage. Alright. Well, good to know. Oh. Thought that was lightning. We're fine though, we got resurrection. And a heal. We're gonna die again. Oh my god. This is terrible. That was a good break. Get all our health, or all our posture back. Managed to hit him during that jump, that was cool. Okay. Oh, we didn't get our resurrection back. Okay. See, sometimes he gets in this rhythm where you just hit him like 5 times. Keep the pressure on with shurikens. There we go. Okay, he's attacking the wall now. Nice swear I've never died to this third phase more than once. Make sure. Oh. Thought we were doing the lightning. Okay, do the lightning. Yeah, there you go. Almost screwed that up. Okay, thank God. That was way harder than it should have been. Well, we get some levels now. Stream took one attempt. I don't know how we did that, looking back. I feel like I'm playing much worse, not on stream. You'd think it would be the other way around. Okay, now we're going to head to the Sunken Valley, which has my favorite boss, period, in any game. Ow. Don't grab me. Oh, why do I do this? If I put a death counter in, I'll have to include all the embarrassing deaths. Unfortunately, all the monkeys are evil somehow, so you have to kill them all. Ow. Stop. Nope. Okay. I think they can shoot me during this. Nope. Please don't. Why did I do that? Right. Final Fantasy VII Remake, you run with that button. So there is a mini boss here, but all it gives is a prayer bead and it's optional, so there's really no reason to do it besides for fun, so maybe I'll try one attempt and then... I don't know why I just jumped off that cliff. We'll give this boss one try and then we'll forget about it. Because we do have to fight it later anyway. Yeah, you know what, we fight it. I'll give it one try. Okay. Well, that was bad. Okay, yeah. You know what? Bye-bye. Just forget about that one. Ow. Okay, we're just gonna leave. Don't shoot me. Okay, we're good. And there we go. So yeah, we have to fight that boss later anyway, so... And we don't gain anything at all by fighting it here, so... Might as well just do it later. We do have this guy, though. Oh, that sucked. Couldn't roll. Kind of in a corner, but we're good. Alright. That one probably should have been first try, but whatever. To watch out for the giant snake. Yeah, that killed. Oh. Did I not rest? Yeah, I guess not. Is it gonna move or? Yeah, I'm impatient. Well, that worked. This is where the monkeys really turn evil. That one has a gun somehow. I don't know how. But it does. And a hat. Okay, this is the only place in the game where I'll ever use a combat art. This one. Because you can hit all the monkeys. Okay, we got a lot of them down. Not all of them, though. Can I just run past this part?
Here we go. So we're already almost dead. Good start. And use the same firecracker trick as the bull. Oh, he swiped me. And we can do this as well. Okay, we're already out of heals, so not going too hot. Oh, that was not a good trade. That wasn't terrible for a first attempt. Oh, come on. Hit the trade again. How did that miss? What is he doing? Oh, barely. Oh no. Okay. Alright. There's a hidden phase two. Now he's an undead ape. Good thing about this phase is that it's not that hard once you know how to do it. Yeah, if he does this move like five times, then we're good. We can use loaded spear to deal a ton of posture damage by getting that scorpion thing, centipede thing out of his neck hole. Yeah, okay, he's being very cooperative so far. Like, extremely cooperative. Wow, okay. He really wants to die. Might have been able to get him there, but just in case. There we go. Nice. I don't think we got hit on that second phase. That boss is awesome. That one was definitely less tries than the stream, but we started without the loaded spear technique on that one, so. And now we're off to, well, there are a few places we could go. I might leave this one here, though. I'm not sure how this is gonna go, how I'm gonna edit this. But if I do leave this one here, thanks for watching. I know this is really different than the content that's been going up over the past year, but this one was pretty fun. I don't know. If you like the voice, let me know. I know a lot of people really like the text, and I know a lot of people want voice. I don't know if this is the style of voice that you had in mind, but yeah, let me know. And I'll take it into consideration when I make future videos. I think the Stardew series is going to be text for the rest of that to keep it consistent. After that, we'll see. I might stick with text, who knows. But it's nice to try voice. Anyway, thanks for watching. Have a good day, everyone.